Hey there, my name is Ben and I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. In today's video, what we're going to do is we're going to create this effect where we're going to do vertex manipulation based off of a texture, right? Even doing from this smiley face effect, right? You can kind of see a smiley face kind of doing its cool thing, but it's often used in using cloudy textures that kind of create this type of effect. Cool, let's jump right into it. Okay, so the setup we have in our shader is actually quite simple. As you can see, we have no main texture. Also, we have our only printing out the UVs. We're only printing out the UV.x because we really only need to use the x value to drive this effect. And we also have the vertex here because we're doing vertex manipulation. Now, in order for us to do vertex manipulation, what we need to do is modify this vertex. So first, I'm going to create a float 3. I'm going to call it vert is equal to v.vertex. Then I'm going to replace this with vert. Simple enough so far. So to kind of demonstrate how this is going to work, I'm just going to quickly manipulate vert dot, I believe the y is equal to o.uv.x. And this is just going to kind of move it a little bit. As you can see, the orange outline here is our is where our quad originally is, and where it's red, it's kind of moving towards us, towards the camera. If you look at this as a way of display, right? It's moving towards the camera. Cool. So in order for us to create a wave effect, what we want to do is we just need to modify our o.uv.x, right? So let's go ahead and take that and modify this. We'll make it, we'll just throw it in a sine wave and we'll multiply it by a factor. And I think that should be it. Yeah, as you can see, wherever it is dark, it is going away from us and red is coming towards us, towards the camera, right? These colors are here only just to demonstrate what's happening. Of course, it doesn't have to be that way, right? We can just do this and you can see that it's still working. The red is really just a visual representation for us. All right, so the next thing we want to do is add a little bit of time. So we can quickly do that just by simply multiplying this by time.y. I've multiplied the wrong value. It seems to be now going in and out, which is kind of a cool effect. Now, multiplying by time, of course, isn't quite right. It's supposed to be simply add. There we go. So yeah, that is it, really. We've created a simple wave effect just by manipulating the vertex shader a little bit, and we've already created this wave effect. Now, one thing, if you want to do a circular wave effect, all we got to do is manipulate this value so that it uses length instead. So a simple way to do that is take our o.uv. We want to make it equal to o.uv times 2 minus 1. Once we've changed the space, all we got to do is do a length. Now we can just do a length because we're going to do the length from the center of the o.uv xy, right? And just by simply doing that, now we've created an effect where the ripple is kind of coming from the outside in. Of course, changing this will control the way it's being rippled in and out. It does seem like this mesh is has a high amount, doesn't have a lot of verts, therefore it makes it not very smooth. If we have a mesh that's extremely tessellated, this will be much smoother. Yeah, so as you can see here, I've used a much higher tessellated plane. It's working a lot better, looking a lot smoother, not kind of jagged like the other one. All right, so I want to take this one step further. This is really cool and all, but what if we wanted to use textures to try to manipulate this? So we want to be able to sample a texture from the vertex. And all we really need to do is sample one single channel. So we'll just do a float. We'll just call it, I guess it's going to be an X modifier, right? So what we need to do is do a texture 2D sample in the vertex. A texture 2D sample in the vertex requires text LOD, text 2D, LOD. And what we need to do is, the reason for this is because text 2D doesn't work in the vertex shader. You need LOD because you also need to pass in the MIPS of what level you're sampling at. So let's bring back our main texture here. Let's also make sure we can do sampler 2D down here. Next, what we want is we want to be able to sample this main text here in text 2D LOD. And what this text 2D LOD, it takes in a vertex 4. And the first two values will be the UVs, so O.UV, right? Dot XY, 0, and then the MIP level. We'll do MIP level number 1. Let's take our XMOD, and we will also do the same thing, times 2 minus 1. We no longer need to do length, but instead we will simply do XMOD here. And let's have a look. All right, so the first thing we need to do is pass in a texture for this to work with. There you go, that looks pretty cool. So what this is doing is actually using the texture and it's doing a sine wave based on the texture's red channel, right? I think we can change the different textures. You can kind of see what's happening here. These are kind of all the same, but if we use a UV map, it's just using the red channel. So it's doing its movement along here. But yeah, usually a cloudy texture can kind of create much cooler effects, right? Especially if the cloudy texture has been smoothened, right? So if we choose a texture like this, you can kind of see that it's now actually a ring texture. Textures like this, you can kind of see it, the red channel is being pushed along this image here, or these images, right? But a cloudy texture is usually what works best. Cool, that is it for me. I mean, if you guys like what you see, please do like, subscribe, and support my channel. And I'll see you guys next time.